Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and welcome back to the Wales campaign. This is part number 16 in the campaign, and we're doing fantastic. Look at this, we have taken London, we've taken Canterbury, the South is under our control, Wales is under our control, parts of the Midlands are under our control as well. We've pushed north as far as Carlisle and defeated an army here, and England are down to what I believe to be about 5 settlements. So it's Norwich, Nottingham, Lincoln, York, and then Newcastle upon Tyne. I think they have over here as well, they have Dublin, so 6 settlements altogether, but as far as the mainland is concerned, I think it's just the 5 settlements. So what we're going to do in this part is we're going to try and wipe out as many English settlements that are remaining. We're going to now stack up some of our armies and some of our forces and start pushing forward. So we've got this guy here, Maerdhi. He's going to be reinforcing. He's going to be heading towards Nottingham. There's a large English army here, Captain Philip. I need to try and avoid him, if possible, with Captain Riddich. Lincoln is there for the taking as well. Nottingham is the big prize. That is, of course, the English capital. It would be nice if we could take that this part as well. I have Captain Caradog going towards Nottingham, and he can reinforce the units in this fort. And if so, then that would be useful. We could actually recruit in this fort as well. Some Sherwood archers, which might not be a bad idea, although they do have a recruitment cost of 800 and an upkeep of 250. I might have to just get one of them. And we'll get them just to reinforce our settlement here. Well, our fort, I should say. My spy, of course, he can move across just to give me a little bit more line of sight. My diplomat can actually head down here. And as you can see, Newcastle upon Tyne. Oh my god, spear militia. We can probably take this as well. Right, plan B, or plan A, or some sort of plan at least. We need to be heading towards there. Maybe Carlisle can recruit something. Oh no, it can't. It can not retrain either. I need to get a force up there quickly, don't I? Where to build from? Just looking around now. Oxford is quite unhappy with me, although I am building stuff, so that will deteriorate soon. I've got low tax rate on to help them out as well. Going to keep some of these units in the fort to help me with a free upkeep. London's army. I am building a few units at London, or retraining them, so that's fine. I can stay like it is. This army, of course, is going Nottingham. I'm just going to double check everything. Canterbury is holding on. What do we have? 4 units there, including bows. 4 units, including some ballista. So we may have our work cut out holding on to Canterbury at the moment, because most of our units are, in fact, bow units. We don't have much of an infantry, do we? So we may want to be thinking about getting some units there. I could get a cog as well, which I might actually do. That cog can be sent to Winchester. I'm going to build a navy at Winchester, which I've already started doing with a couple of cogs. And then I'm going to patrol the waters eventually and try and take Ireland and Scotland. But not much I can do now, I don't think. Let's just double check. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it for this turn. So I'm going to click end turn. We'll be on turn number 20. So here we go. Oh, my merchant. Forgot to move the merchant. As expected, this large English army decided to come out and attack me. Bang. I'm going to retreat. No point fighting this because we're not going to win. Withdraw. And yes, they are going to chase me, I think. So it's going to be an auto-resolve and it's going to be a loss. Don't mind that, though, because I know where they are. 540 men just automatically resolve. Clear defeat, which we expected. Oh, and some Englishmen have come out. Oh, and who is this? Is this Anselm of Bapton, I wonder? Could it be? Could it finally be him? It is! He's finally attacked me. He's attacked Captain Caradog. And the balance of power is actually in his favour very much so. I don't know what army he has. I'm going to withdraw from this battle, though. A tactical withdraw and odds. Yes, there we go. That's fine. He actually can't chase us down now. So betrothed Iago of Ceredigion is Gladys Madog. Like our Explorers Guild. Not going to worry about that for now. Right in Oxford. We need to sort that out. So first of all, let's move Maerdhi towards Nottingham, because that's where all the battles are kind of going towards at the moment. Your forces melt away, we know that. End of turn report. Look at that. Overall, population and production, Wales are in the lead. So We're doing fantastically well, and we're actually making quite a bit of money now as well. A profit of 8,000, which is great. Most advanced faction is us as well. Construction report. Recruitment report. And I'm just going to skip through to marriage celebrations. So, plenty to look forward to there. My ship... Oh, I actually can't get out because the Irish Navy for some reason is staying there. That's fine. That will melt away eventually. So, what to do? London. I think we might have to be fighting Anselm of Bapton. Let's see what he has. So, he has some decent units here. He's got some Sherwood archers. He has... Yes, he has quite a lot of units, doesn't he? Now, I could, of course, not fight him with him and fight him with the king, which might be the best bet. But I want to get my army to reinforce, don't I? So, yes, we're going to do that, I think. Just going to double check. Cavalry, militia. Some of these units are militia, though, so they should break fairly quickly. I'm going to be pressing my advantage by not attacking Nottingham quite yet. No point attacking Nottingham at the moment. We're going to go for this army here instead. We're going to fight this battle. Vortimer Howell versus Captain Roberts. Let's fight this battle on the battle map. My plan is to go and take Lincoln with this army instead. Nottingham can be taken out by the southern army. This northern army can go and take Lincoln. And then perhaps we can think about taking York or Newcastle as well. Or at the very least reinforcing. Let's start my deployment. And let's get things going. So first of all, I want to group up my general and the cavalry. Put them into a formation at the back of the line. That would be very nice for me. Then we get all the bows. I have plenty of them. They're all going to be grouped. We're going to put the skirmishers with them. Oh, actually, no. We won't need the skirmishers. We'll just put them into a formation like so. Nice straight line. Like so. We're going to deploy stakes where possible, and make sure we have flaming arrows on. Want to get that advantage going for us. The skirmishers can actually stay just behind like so. Then we don't have much of an infantry, so it's going to be a very difficult battle to win with very few infantry units, but we will try our best. If it only just weakens them, that would be good enough for me. They do have billmen and heavy infantry, and I'm actually, let's have a quick look to see what would be the best flank to take. They only have four units, so armored sergeants, billmen, spearmen. The heavy infantry side would be the best place for the cavalry. Shouldn't take as many losses as they would against spearmen. So we're going to walk our cavalry to the right flank and hopefully go for a charge. I'm actually going to be pushing my units forward, my infantry forward. They don't have any missile units, so the plan will be to hold them up here and just keep firing upon them with the missile troops. I'm actually going to bring my skirmishers forward because they can actually get a few early hits on some of the armoured sergeants for me if possible. And I think that's a good plan to start off with. Infantry at the spikes, bowmen to fire and to weaken. They have taken some of them out already, particularly some of the armoured sergeants. 58 and 60. This is good so far. Happy enough with this. The skirmishers can be my troops that will just be wasted, basically, which I don't mind. They can hold them up to help me get a few more shots our way. That's fine. Time for a charge, I think. We can charge the heavy infantry now. Chance to go for the charge. There we go. One charge in. Second charge. They should break, hopefully. They are breaking. Yes, they are breaking. Excellent. So far, so good. A little bit scrappy, but I don't care. It's doing the job. And we have armoured sergeants, which are spearmen, which we're not going to be attacking, of course. I'm going to tell my one unit of cavalry to charge the billmen that are routing over there. They have lost half their men. And all of my bows can actually fire upon the armoured sergeants, which are here, while we hold up the units at the centre. I can't really charge into them because they are spearmen, of course. They are taking losses. 34. This is good. Constant fire from all my units. It's going to weaken them. They are going to break eventually. The general can actually go for a charge into the rear now. Now he's killed all of them. Let's have a quick look at this. Into the back, which is what I want. And yeah, with that charge, we've killed the general. They should break. That should be it now. There we go. Excellent. End the battle. Only lost 33. Very happy with that. That works very well for us. Prisoners captured ransom. Accepted a bit more cash for us. Taken the fort, which is very good. Trait increase of Vought Bahawal. He's got plus one command because he's a promising commander. Now we can think about pushing to Lincoln, which is what we're going to be doing. That's our first plan, because Nottingham, it's such a big settlement anyway, and you know, it's a fortress, and it's also got very good units, so we're going to be going for Lincoln instead. And the king is going to be pushing out now. He's actually going to be attacking Anselm of Baptum. We're going to have a big battle in this part. I was hoping that my army would reinforce, which it hasn't. Oh my, I didn't want that to happen, did I? Although the king should be... They got militia compared to us. We're going to fight this battle, and if we do draw or lose, we know that we got Captain Caradog nearby to have a second battle. A night battle actually gives their commander another unit of another star of command, so we're going to keep that off. We're going to fight. This is the biggest battle of the campaign so far, 658 versus 801. They have a slight unit advantage, but we have the king, who of course will have many hit points. He has fantastic traits, and on top of that, we also have better equipped units, in my opinion. I think some of their units are militia, whereas we have genuine spearmen. We are in the snow again, which is unfortunate. Now, I'm thinking where the best place to attack would be. Nice hill up here, although the siege equipment would be blocked. Nice hill to work with up here as well. So I'm going to actually deploy where the space is. And what we're going to do is group up every single spear unit. Put them as my main line in front. It's not quite the formation that we want. That's better. Spear units like so. The English billmen and heavy billmen are going to be my second line. And they're going to be put into a formation just behind. Gwent raiders are going to be in front of the siege equipment to protect. And then we're going to have the bows grouped up as well. They're going to be in the front, as you would expect. Put them into a formation like so. And I'm actually going to deploy these here so they can put spikes in front of my siege equipment. And they can go back at the front then. And then finally, the cavalry can be grouped up. We're going to go on the left flank to begin with. Put them there. So there we go, start the battle. Cavalry's going to take a left turn, basically. It's going to go down the hill. I'm going to tell my siege equipment to start firing upon the English. I didn't think this through. I should have put the spikes, probably... Oh, I haven't got the spikes. That's a shame. Oh, of course, I moved them. Ah, fail. I failed. So they're going to be sitting ducks where they are right now. I'm hoping to try and tease them to come towards me. They have some well-armoured bow units, so it's going to be quite difficult to defeat them bow for bow or blow for blow. So these are the militia. These should break relatively easily. So the second line is going to be the weakest, and then they have cavalry. And they have siege equipment of their own, plus the general, so plenty to kind of be wary of. I don't really want to march down there. They have the hill advantage if I do go down. Although saying that, I could go down a little bit, so what we'll do, I think, is change our angle slightly. Put them there, the spearmen at the front. And at the back, Gwent raiders go there. Bows can just go in the front. That should be... Okay, I think. General going on the left flank. I'm hoping to try and flank around. We'll actually go to about here with the general. Should be okay. I'm going to take my time with this battle, because this is a big battle, and I think this is the biggest English army on the campaign map at the moment. It has been all campaign, and if we can weaken it in this battle, or even defeat it in this battle, then we should be okay. Get fire at will turned on. Get some flaming fire going as well. And hopefully we can start firing in a few moments as my units group up ready. Let's have a quick look at my units. There they are. Look at them. Beautiful Welshmen. Those Gwent Raiders look fantastic with the armor as well. Lovely. Lovely stuff. Anyway, we are in fact going to be firing with the ballista. Hopefully a couple of shots can be fired. Should get some decent hits. I'm going to keep the ballista just by there. I'm doing this because the archers might be in range if they go a bit further closer. My bow units can in fact be brought closer with the rest of my line now. Just going to gently kind of envelop, well not envelop quite yet, but gently bring the units all forward. Gwent Raiders go on the right flank actually. Hopefully we can get a few kills. Just going to try and tease them with the ballista. They have 58 archers. Oh, that was a very good shot there. 58 down to, what do we get? We got 2 kills. And it does look like they are going to spread out a little bit now as well. They are archer militia, so their range wouldn't be the same. So I probably could afford to come forward a bit more, which is what I'm going to be doing, just slightly, just a little bit. Go to the left flank slightly as well. And hopefully we can do well. My cavalry is just in position now. Or near enough. I'm just going to go behind them slightly. Like that. A few more shots. Doesn't matter if we overhit too much because we can take up the town militia. And this is it. It's mainly militia. So I think blow for blow we could probably defeat them. But it's protecting what we have really. And they might be going for the charge right about now, which they are indeed. They're going to go and bring the archers forward. So what we're going to be doing is bringing our archers just a little bit closer to the action. Tell my ballista to halt. And now everything can start to move up. So we have my bows going forward first of all. Units can go forward. Archer militias coming down now to attack. Which is very nice to see. And I could actually take him with the cavalry, but the cavalry's too far away at the moment. I don't mind this. They're going to bring archer militia to the battle, and I could actually divide them up from the main line. Just wish the cavalry was a bit closer, but it's not the end of the world. Their ballista's actually in range now as well. Ooh. Right, I tell you what, it's going to be time to actually attack them now, I think. So the spearmen can actually charge. The billmen can actually charge. All my bow units can actually charge. Gwent Raiders are going to charge. My cavalry can be held into position until this time. They got lots of cavalry, see, and I need to be using the spearmen against them. Militia. It's all militia, so yeah, we should be okay. I'm actually going to tell my ballista to aim up the line. Same with the catapult, get them all to aim up there. Break off some of these units, get them to chase the other way. We're going to slowly march to the left now. There's town militia there, they should be able to be broken easily. Gwent Raiders are going to be engaging the Sherwood archers if possible. Try and get some kind of formation going. And the Maronite spearmen are going to jump straight in. Only 12 of them. Straight into the centre. We need to get in there to reinforce actually. Just get everything thrown in now. This is a very unorganised charge. There we go. Look at that. They're all charging now. I'm going to hit the centre of the line. And now I'm going to go for a charge with the cavalry on the town militia to try and break that left flank. While I continue to reinforce, this is going to be quite nip and tuck this is. I'm hoping that we can break. Heavy build militia defeats the sink possibility, and my cavalry's going to go for the charge on the town militia now. Llewellyn's going to jump right into it. Hopefully we can break the town militia. Which appears to be working. We've routed the archer militia. Gonna pull the king out briefly. You can go for a second charge. And we are still killing people with the... Oh shit, we need to get the cavalry out there now. Dudes, get out. The spearmen have come across to reinforce, that's fine. Breaking parts of the center. And the center's breaking. We're breaking the center. Ballista can actually aim for the general. Cavalry did well to distract long enough. This is going well so far. Keep killing the center. And I go for a second charge on the town militia, even though spearmen are nearby. I'm going to be careful when I go for the charge. If they bring their feudal knights into the fight, then they are going to lose because they are going to be against spearmen. General's going to go for a charge, second charge. Town militia should break. Decent charge. Break. Oh, surely they got to break. 14, 13, come on. Can't stay there too long. Units are routing all over the place. Whales are killing them all. And they haven't broken on this left flank. Let's get the generals back to there. Oh, and they're breaking now. Excellent. Get out there quickly because the spearmen are there. I don't want to lose my general. Can't afford to lose the king at this stage in the campaign. Archers fire on the left flank. Scythier bowmen. It's a complete massacre at the moment. Spear militia there. Archers are up here. We're going to charge the archers with the cavalry now. Going to tell the one cavalry to go for the other archer militia. The center needs to hold as long as possible. They're going to bring more spearmen into the fight, so let's kind of attack them. Probably best that I group up some of these units now. Try and get them into a Shiltron formation, perhaps. Something to consider, I think, although we are chasing many of them off the field. I'm going to ignore the archer militia. They're going to charge the spear in the rear because I need to reinforce the center at the moment. So my cavalry can actually come downhill for a charge and hopefully get a few kills with this charge. We are starting to lose some men. Some Marinoi spearmen are routed in, but I've charged straight into the back. Lord have mercy. We've lost half of our men. Llewellyn needs to get up there and charge as well. Cavalry needs to get out there quickly. We're going to get surrounded by Bill Militia otherwise. And we are losing all of a sudden. We've lost most of our infantry in the centre. This is what I didn't want. I might need to do a tactical retreat in at any moment now. I'm going to retreat. The king needs to get out there quickly. Damn. Let's get my siege equipment out as well. My infantry, or most of my infantry, is actually routed. It couldn't hold the line that long. Heller Bowman. Going to get routed as well. The king is actually surrounded, I think. No, he's not. He's fine. They're all routed as well. Right. We're going to lose my catapults, unfortunately. Don't mind. Don't mind this at all. Because we have that reinforcing army. We've taken lots of Englishmen out. We've killed 60% compared to 65%. That number advantage is what's doing it for them at the moment. Hopefully we can take out some of these units that are chasing us down. Let's attack the general's bodyguard, actually. With the remaining units. Let's go to the king. I'm actually going to get Llewellyn to chase down. Where are they gone? I think they've routed, actually. They have routed. Get him to go to the edge of the battlefield. It's been a complete mess so far. Just looking to see where everything is. We're going back uphill. Let's fire upon the general's bodyguard. and the feudal knights, and maybe we can take a few of them out. Catapult crew charge in to distract. Right, this is fine. There's a chance to kill Alistair of Bapton here if we can just take our chance. Units have routed. I see opportunity to kill a general. If we just keep firing upon him. Keep firing. Keep firing, come on. Unfortunately, don't think it's going to work. We're going to get chased away from the battlefield. Although we've reduced the heavy cavalry to 4. Not too bad. Get the king out of the field. He can fight another day. All my infantry is routed as well.
Our army is tiring.
Keep firing, come on. Yes, that's what I wanted. A few more units, or men in that unit are dead. 3 of them in fact. The general's down to 5 now. Couple of good shots there. We are being chased away. Let's withdraw with them. What's going on with the general? What's going on with the king? I put him towards the edge of the field and he's actually gone the other way. He's being chased, I think. Don't know. Apparently there's some units nearby. I can't see them. For some reason he's going the opposite way. It's weird. Hopefully we can keep him alive. Heavy cavalry down to 4. They will rout, of course. You would think. They gotta be careful for friendly fire though, firing arrows like that. Hopefully we get another shot away, come on. Reload and fire. Fire on the general. General, come behind you. Turn and fire. Oh, it's not going to be... It's going to be too late. It's going to be too late, I think. Can live in hope, though. Yeah, it's going to be too late. I'm going to concentrate on the king because for some reason I'm routing with him and he's going... I'm withdrawn with him, sorry. And he's going towards the English army, which is rather retarded, in my opinion, so... Get him off the field and we're gonna try and get him to safety. Hellier Bowman can attack. The cavalry here. Unit routes. Get a few shots away from me, come on. They're there. Close range shots, that's what we want. A few hits. Fire, come on. They're not firing. Want to take his head, come on. Oh no. Not quite, unfortunately. Hopefully we can get the king to safety. He's lost only one man all battle. Could actually have used the king to reinforce the or take out their general actually, looking at it. I think the possibility was there. I didn't take that possibility. And what do they have nearby? Bows? More bows? More bows, right, turn around, we're gonna go back. The king can go back and fight to the very end. If that's all they've got here. We could take a few units out and then perhaps go for the general. Because he is split up from the main force at the top of that mountain at the moment. And they've taken a big beat in. The king could probably rout lots of these units by himself if I plan this right. He's going to be exhausted, of course, because he's ran around the battlefield. But I think there's an opportunity for me to take out a couple more units to make it easier in the second battle. I'm just going to readjust myself in my chair. Let's do this, guys. Let's try and take out these Sherwood archers at least. Completely handicap the English. I'm going to fast forward. Let's get these unit routes off the screen. This is very risky. I could lose my king by doing this. But there is an opportunity to do this. Let's go back normal speed. Charge these Sherwood archers. They are still reforming, so there is an opportunity to do this. Fast forward. Got them. Go for the second unit. 30 horses remaining. And we've found the second unit. Charge. They should rout. They haven't routed yet. They got better armor, I think. Here we go, we got them. As you can see, feudal knights are charging me downhill. Gonna reform slightly. Run away. Got them down to two. I'm gonna try and get the feudal knights to engage me then. Archer militia are at the top of the hill, that's why I'm running away. There's only four of them, so we might be able to take them out with the king. This is awkward. This is very dangerous stuff that I'm doing right now. But I see an opportunity and I got a good general with good hit points. Gonna charge now and fight. Hopefully we get a decent charge. They're going to be exhausted as well, you would assume. There we go, we got the numbers. Cavalry charge. They are shaken. 26 against 4. Surely there's no contest. And they are gone. We've routed the feudal knights. Let's get out there. That's two units gone. And we need our side of the battlefield as well. We've actually been able to go across the field and get back to the other side of the hill. We might be able to get the archers to chase me. What do they have left? They have spear militia, I've got to avoid them. Heavy build militia, got to avoid them. The general himself. But this is good. We've taken lots of them out and we can take them out. Or we can definitely take them out in a follow-up battle. So I'm going to actually tell him to finally withdraw now. Where are you going, man? Why are you withdrawing that way? This way you want to go. Don't be a retard all your life. The line's right here, so hopefully we can get him across to safety. I think we've done pretty good in defeat. It's a strategic defeat. It's what I would call it anyway. I know I've got that reinforcing army with lots of good infantry units. There we go. We're nearly there now. All we got to do is withdraw. Come on, get across. What the hell? Stop turning around, you fucking idiots. Oh my god, I just paused on accident. I can't retreat with him for some reason. Let's get to the corner. Thing is, I can't charge my general in because I can't win this battle with just cavalry. This is strange. I was hoping to go over that line and retreat, but for some reason he's not letting me. I mean, it is possible to go for a charge on the archer militia, but they're too far away from the main English line. Right, now surely withdraw. Why do they keep turning around when I withdraw? What the hell? I get here. Fast forward. We are faster than them because we are cavalry. Now surely when I click withdraw, gotta be kidding me. Oh look at this, there's a guy caught in the corner of the field. This game's bugging out for some reason, I just don't like it. If we're not careful, we're gonna get killed and lose our general. Oh my god, why can't I withdraw? tactic, withdrawn, look what happens. He goes towards the English army. Archer militia and catapults chasing me down. Come on, I can't afford to lose him. Shit. I'm gonna risk it. I'm gonna click withdraw and see where he goes. This is just retarded though. Why wouldn't you go off the field of the battle? Why would you go this way? I've actually lost a man because of that. Well, that's stupid, isn't it? Luckily, I was able to create a gap to go through, but this is stupid. I could have easily lost the king by doing this. Hopefully, we're just going to get the safety, but my word, that would have been awful if he had died because of that. And we did kill 72% of the enemy, so I'm pretty happy with that. Of course, I'm going to have to rebuild this army. Finally! There we go. Clear defeat, but we killed quite a lot of them. Which is what I can say about that. That probably... We'll have to see what it looks like now on the campaign map. So we've had units captured. We can actually accept this ransom. Because we can afford it. And I got my men, or some of my men, back. But now, of course, Alseb of Bapton is very weak. He got lots of militia units, which I think we can take out. So he's only got 4 men remaining by himself. So we're going to actually attack with my infantry now. A 3-5 rating. I'm going to fight this battle on the battle map. This is going to be an extra long sort of episode to my usual running time of my episodes, because we've got that big battle, of course. This is episode 16. So we are nearing the end of the English kind of section of this camp. I'm going to wait to see what the weather turns into. That's better. We'll go for this kind of weather. And of course we have 4 units of Gwent Raiders, which I'm going to be grouping up into one line, or one block should I say, and I have 3 units of English Billmen, which I'm going to be doing the same thing. I'm blocking them all up, and I'm marching basically towards them. Here we go, it's just going to be a charge straight for them and an attack. Hopefully the infantry can prevail and I can outnumber them. That's my aim. Of course they're going to be hidden in the trees. There they are. Right. Normal speed. Archer militia charging me. 2 central units to charge them. Spear militia can be charged at. Archer militia on the flank and heavy bill militia. We're actually going to send 2 of them there, 1 of them there. Charge that archer militia. Some attack the spear militia and the heavy bill militia. They've reformed their line. We're going to be attacking their main line now. Like so. Gwent Raiders against spear militia. Possibly not the best unit types to attack with. Bouncer force is evenly powered though. I'm going to blow a horn. And my units are bugging out for some reason. I don't like it. Men, get in there. One of these units isn't attacking for some reason. Come on, get in there. There we go. It's better. We can actually attack the archer militia. It's a big massive mosh pit at the moment. I wish I had some spearmen actually to attack the cavalry. Defeat seems certain in the centre though. It's just going to be a big blob. We're blobbing our way in. We're doing a decent enough job, I think, what we killed. We've killed 13% against 12, so we're okay at the moment. Archer militia's getting defeated on this flank, which is good. Maybe we can cause a few units to rout. The spearmen have lost quite a lot of men as well, which is good as well. Militia, of course they are militia, so that's the thing which is going to be going against in our favour. keep pushing against them. But our general is dead, unfortunately. Damn it. Captain Caradog is no more. Hoping we can hold on, though. Oh, we're starting to rout in the center now. That's the problem with these Gwent raiders. I was hoping they'd do well against militia. Oh, no, and the Gwent raiders have broken. But we're doing okay on this flank against the heavy bill militia. They're going to be throwing some archer militia in, I think. So we're going to break off and try and attack them. Oh, this is disappointing. This is very disappointing. The English have resurged in this campaign. They've risen up against the Welsh, and hopefully they're hopefully going to try and defeat me, but damn it. We've been dealt a stinging defeat today. Only lost 33% against 25%, but it was enough to break us. Not too much between us, really, but yeah. Damn it. And this was supposed to be the battle that we took him out, and he's still alive. Anselm of Bapton is still alive. Somehow. We don't have enough units to attack. We're going to stay at London. And we are going to be retraining some of these units, I think. We can get three of them to be retrained this turn, which we will be doing. May as well keep this unit at Arundel. Prisoners have been executed. Bastards. Absolute bastards. My spy needs to go up here. I think there's an English army around here somewhere. There they are. Captain Philip. Need to be wary of him. He's going to be going after Chester or Lancaster, you would assume. So I need to be recruiting units here. So let's get some infantry in. Oh my god. They actually are a decent army as well. Montgomery. Shrewsbury's open as well. That army is actually going to be causing us headaches. So let's get units into Chester quickly. Get the bows in. Montgomery, Cardiff. I got a general here, Traherne of Brycheiniog. Go to Shrewsbury for me. Gwent Raiders can go to Shrewsbury for me as well. They just wasted back there. And then my general, Marathi, is going to continue his path towards... Actually, no, you're going to be going this way for me to help defend instead. You're going to try and take out the captain. We should have enough with London, I think. Just double-checking everything. Winchester, Oxford. I have some units from Oxford that could be brought in. Ballista, I mean. I need them to defend Oxford, though, in case they do attack me. This is quite, it's amazing what one or two defeats can do. They make you rethink your strategy. Although we are attacking Lincoln, and I could actually get some mercenary crossbowmen in as well, which might not be a bad idea. This general can actually get lots of mercenaries, which isn't a bad idea as well. So let's get the mercenaries in. We can afford it at the moment, so this guy is going to take the spearmen to Shrewsbury. Actually, you're going to go north as well. I'm just going to send everything to this sort of area of Lancaster, Chester to help defend against Captain Philip. But I need to think about taking the army up here. So if I take Prince David, for example, bring him out. I can recruit a unit here. Newcastle upon Tyne has spear militia and mailed knights. So we need to be thinking about taking that. But let's get back into Carlisle. Once we can get one or two units from Carlisle, militiamen will do for now, because they're just going to be there as a kind of meat to try and take that settlement. And yeah, I think I'm probably at the end of turn. Canterbury will probably be attacked. My lord. I can't afford any more mercenaries. Oh, this is going to be awkward. Get some spear militia and catapults if at all possible. They might not attack me at Canterbury, but it's worth... I mean, I could sally out, but much better to attack them in a siege. I can put men on the wall and get more kills that way. Right, I think we are okay to end turn, so I'm going to be doing that. End turn. Forgot to move my merchant. And of course, they are going to try and reinforce Lincoln. But they haven't attacked me, which is excellent, because we've now recruited at Canterbury. Bride presented to Vortibor Howell. It were the Hoildhu, so we're going to have you ride in at Oxford. Marriage celebrations, recruitment report. Lots of you have been recruited around the settlements. 27%, 21%. Oh my god, just gonna keep you in there for now. Right, Marithi. Do I go right or left with you? That, oh, I don't like this. Oh, Captain Philip went to... That's good. That's really good, actually. Right, so what we can do is send you to Chester. You can go to Lancaster. That looks a lot better already, right. Then you are going to go to Shrewsbury. And you are going to go to Montgomery. Right. Reinforces all of them slightly. Traherne of Brycheiniog is going to be going towards Captain Philip. You're going to be going towards Captain Philip. I think that's a good idea. That's a very good idea. Now, Anselm of Bapton, of course, is down on quite a few units now. And I could probably take him out with a full might of London. Which would be very nice for me. We'll probably have this battle, the return battle, in the second or in the next part. Once he's gone, we are pretty much good to go throughout the whole... I can retrain lots of units here as well. Let's retrain the Hellwood Bowmen and the English Billmen for now. Fairground maybe? Increase tradable goods. Get a fairground here. I'm just going to be rebuilding Oxford as much as I can. Public order is okay at the moment, I think, anyway. Just a little bit of rioting. 36% Welsh. It's insurgency, unrest. Squalor, the garrison is helping, the law is helping, the tax bonus and the buildings of entertainment fund, culture and maintenance is always going to help, so we can't do much more than that. I can recruit some more units, which is going to be needed, I think, so let's get some spear militia in to help out with the garrison. And yeah, I think we're going to end this episode here, so in the next part, we will be, of course... Oh, I can actually... To battle it is, then, sire. Hang on a minute, guys. I'm going to auto-resolve this. Clear victory. There we go. I'm happy with that. Taken Lincoln. So, nice way to end the episode. Taken Lincoln. We're going to try and defend Lincoln for our lives now. I'm going to actually exterminate the population as well. As you commanded, sire. To help with the public order. Resistance is futile. I took it last time and I couldn't keep it, so I'm just going to exterminate them all this time. So there we go, we've taken Lincoln. We're going to be fighting Anselm of Bapton in the second battle against him, and hopefully we can kill him this time. And we are basically moving troops around the lands to try and reinforce some of our border settlements. I think next we're going to aim towards taking Newcastle and then go down and take Nottingham as well. But anyway, guys, I've been Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.